Throughout the Gospels, Jesus works many wonders and miracles, and not in a way which we would think. We do not see Jesus healing with bolts of lightning or casting out demons with armies of angels. Rather, Jesus uses the ordinary to heal and reconcile us, God's creation, back to the Father. Today, we see Jesus heal the mother-in-law of Peter, who is suffering from a fever. A fever doesn't seem like that grave of an illness, but what Mark wants us to see is that she is very ill. She suffers alone and in isolation, something that I think in this COVID world we all can relate to. Jesus took her by the hand and helped her up. What is important is the word Mark uses for helped or raised her up is the same word in Greek that he uses for the resurrection. This healing is a restoration, a transformation of her life from sorrow to love. This simple act of charity restored the woman to her proper state. It allowed her not just to live again without fever, but moved her to serve the Lord. The healings that Jesus performed offer us a sign of his divinity, as they did for the people of his time. But notice how he went on to heal so many others. Our lives, touched and changed by Christ, especially through the sacraments, should spur us to spread the news of our own healings. These interactions should move others to seek that which we have found, namely conversion, communion, salvation, and redemption. In Mark's Gospel, Jesus' healing ministry begins in the house of Peter. This is significant, and not by accident, because it foreshadows the primacy of Peter as Prince of the Apostles. It gives us a clue to where we can find healing, even now. The healing of Christ is present in the Church of Peter. It is almost as if the great gift of healing was taught to Peter by the Lord himself at this point, not to be used again by him until after the resurrection and sending of the Holy Spirit. For we know that in the Acts of the Apostles, Peter heals the cripple simply when his shadow falls upon him. How great is it that Christ took away our infirmities and bore our diseases, namely sin and death, so that we may live. Job, who we read from in today's first reading, suffered greatly. He cries out to the Lord that his days begin and end without hope, that his life is like wind and he will never again see happiness. I cannot help but think that many people are thinking this way today. When will things be normal? It seems like life is just blowing by and we're missing what makes it worth living. Peter's mother-in-law, along with anyone who has suffered great illness, loneliness, or isolation, knows that feeling of abandonment. Yet there is hope, great hope, for we know that Jesus went before us to prepare a place of life and save us from death. He takes our hand and in times of trial and distress lifts us to a place of hope in our world. By our baptism, we have already been healed, and we continue to seek that which can be ours, eternal happiness. Some days we cry out in misery to God like Job, but after darkness, morning comes, where again we see the light of Christ, the light which heals us and guides us. Christ works in our lives in an ordinary way. May we keep our eyes of faith open so that when he passes by, we may recognize him.